ಪ್ರತಿಕೂಲೇಶು ದುಃಖ ಹೇತುಷು ಯಶಮಾನೇಶು
ಶ್ರೂಯಮಾನೇಶು
ಸ್ಮರ್ಯಮಾನೇಶು ಯಃ ದ್ವೇಷಃ ಸಃ ಕ್ರೋಧಃ.
This is anger. What is that anger? See, krodha cha. The krodha, anger is being defined. Atmanah pratikuleshu dukkha hetu. Dukkha hetu. Cause of sorrow. Sorrow for who? Myself, oneself. See, when? See, what you do? Drishyamaneshu. When you see a cause of sorrow, or Shruyamaneshu, when you hear a cause of sorrow, or Smaryamaneshu, when you remember a cause of sorrow, what happens in your mind? Yahadveshaha. What hatredness, enmity that is born in your mind. That is what saha krodha. Doesn't you think of an enemy? Fine. This is desire, this is anger. How am I to know that I have a desire? How am I to know I am angry? You can know angry, stand in front of mirror. That if you are angry, you can know. How am I to know when I have a desire? Let us see.
Tau kama krodho udbhavaha yasya vegasya saha kama krodho udbhavaha vegaha.
So first he defines vega. See, what is to be curtailed? The vega force, the public expression, overt expression of desire and anger, that is to be controlled. What is kama? This defined. What is krodha? Defined. Now, the vega means for which these two are the causes. What are the causes? Tau kama krodha. Those kama krodha. Tau means what? Those two which have been defined right now. Kama krodha. Udbhavaha. Udbhavaha is cause of birth. Cause of birth. Udbhavaha. Yasya vegasya. The vega, the force which has got this kama and krodha as its cause. Saha kama krodha udbhava vega. Means force born of desire and anger. Now, such a vega is born in me. How am I to know? Is explained.
Romanchana.
Romanchana.
Drushta netra vadanadi lingaha.
Drushta netra vadanadi lingaha.
Antakarana prakshova rupaha.
Antakarana prakshova rupaha.
Kamodbhavaha vegaha.
Kamodbhavaha vegaha.
This is the vega, force born of desire. What is it? No. This is yes. This is a description of the vega born of desire. What is it? Romanchana. Romanchana is horripilation. You know what is horripilation? Stand erect. So, horripilation, romanchana. When we use the word romanchana, horripilation means all over the body, the stand is, the hair is little more, not that vertically erect. Romanchana. Rishta netra vadana. Rishta netra, cheerful eyes. Rishta vadana, cheerful face. अरे आज क्या हो गया? You seem to be very cheerful. Something is there. So, rishta netra, cheerful eyes, rishta vadana, cheerful is Adi Linga, character of the Adi. Adi is what? Ha ha, hoo hoo. Hilariousness. Adi Linga. What is it actually? Antakarana Prakshobha Rupa. It is an excitement and agitation in the antakarana. See, when you are happy, happy one, you are excited, isn't it? When you are sorrowful, you are dejected. Both useless to gain Atmajnana. Both are useless to get Atmajnana. You want, mind must be shanta. Prakshobha Rupa in the form of agitation or the excitement of the mind, that is Kamodhavaha Vega. It is the Vega force born of Kama desire. What about the Krodhodhavaha Vega force born of anger? Let us see.
Gatra Prakampa.
This is the force or the external appearance of what? Of the anger. Gatra Kampa. Limbs are trembling. You should see such people. Limbs are trembling. Prasveda. Profusely perspiring. Sandashta Aushta Putta. Biting the lips and the teeth. By sandashta aushta puta means the biting the lips and the teeth. See, oshta puta means the cavity made by opening the lips. Oshta puta means cavity made by opening the lips. Sandashta oshta puta means biting the lips and the teeth. Do you do or not? So this is your experience. So the rakta netra, eyes become red, rakta netra. Adi linga. Adi for what? Shouting, howling, beating. So Adi. See, you know, have you seen a child getting angry? What is that? it can't be think further. It starts beating his legs and you see, or hit the head. They hit the head. So that is anger. Krodhodhavega. Now continue.
Tam kama krodhodhavam vegam. Yaha utsahate sodhum, prasahitum, yaha saha yuktaha, yogi, sukhicha, iha loke naraha.
Now you know what is kama vega, what is krodha vega, what is to be done. Not to keep in the throat books. You see, you have to control them. You have to bring them under the mastery of yours. So that will say, tam krodho tam kama krodho dvam vega. That force, that is open expression of the desire and the anger. Say, yaha, where may be. Sodhum prasahitum utsahate. Utsahate means is capable, is able, can, that means one who dares them, who is able, able to what? Sodhum. Sodhum means what? Prasahit, prasahitu. One is able to bear them, put the means to stop them. So that is saha yuktaha. Yuktaha means that person is capable of making the mind get absorbed in Swarupa provided. Jnana is yogi. One has accomplished the yoga. See, yogi means one who has made the mind absorbed in the Swarupa. Yuj samadho. So, yuj means it is to make the mind absorbed in the dhyaya. The thing to be meditated upon. Yogi, and certainly he is who? Sukhicha. Sukhicha is also happy. Where? Iha. Iha means loke naraha. So that person is sukhi. So that means what should be done? Before that, one should have mastery over this open expression of kama and krodha. This is to begin with. Afterwards he says, get rid of kama and krodha. So here what is there? He has taken for granted kama and krodha. You have to attack what? Vega. But afterwards he says, get rid of both kama and krodha. Then only you can certainly make your mind absorbed in the Swarupa. The question is now, so the finale of knowledge is total abidance in the Atma Swarupa. To know what exactly is this absorption in the Atma Swarupa. So Lord Krishna is now demonstrating or describing a person whose mind is absorbed in the Atma Swarupa. Like this now. Embodiment. Embodiment is given. This is what it is like that. This is what it is. Katham.
Katham bhutascha brahmani sthitaha brahma prapnoti iti aha.
If a question is like this, katham bhutascha, of what nature, of what type of person, see, and who is that person? Brahmani sthitaha. One who is abiding, one who is absorbed in Brahma. Where are you, Sita? Asane Sita. You are sitting where? On your seat, carpet or chair or something. Is it not? Yes or no? So where are you? I am in the classroom. If you ask Jnani, where are you? I am in the body, he will say. This has come earlier, has come earlier. Katha mudra brahmanista. Yeah, brahmanista means one whose mind is absorbed in Brahma, in contrast to Vishaya sthitaha, that we are. Vishaya sthitaha? Vishaya sthitaha, Vishayeshu. He is what? Brahmani. What makes you Vishayasita? First, do you agree that you are Vishayasita? What makes you Vishayasita? Mind is totally preoccupied where? In the Vishaya. Brahmanisita, mind is totally absorbed where? Simple. So what you do? Shift the focus. Shift the focus. Your focus is where? You are doubtful still? You did not tell me, but you know yourself. So, therefore, this, so that is what Brahma Chitara. Brahma Pravnavati, who gains Brahma, who is that person whose mind is so absorbed in the Brahma and he gains Brahma? What is his nature? Listen for Lord Krishna and his God.
Yodha Sukhondara Ramaha.
Yodha Sukhondara Ramaha.
Tathantar Jyotirevayaha.
Tathantar Jyotirevayaha.
Sayogi Brahma Nirvanam.
Sayogi Brahma Nirvanam.
Brahma Bhuto Digacchati.
Brahma Bhuto Digacchati.
This is a person who is Brahmanishitaha Brahma Prabhuti. Yaha. Yaha means where maybe? It is also a pronoun. It is not said man, woman. It is not said Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. Rich, poor, nationality. Nothing is there. One who has got the Brahma. You know, see, certain embodiments other than human also can gain knowledge. Anuman, who is he? Monkey, Jnani. There are that business, big, big snakes in the patalas. Jnanis. So they are. Who? Vibhishana, Rakshasa, Jnani. So that is. Yaha, where may be? Antasukha.
Anvaya.
Yaha, Antasukha, Antararamaha, Tatha, Yaha, Antaha, Jyotihi. Eva. Antaha, Jyotihi, Eva. Saha, Yogi. And iha eva brahma bhuta and san brahma nirvanam adhigacchati brahma bhuta and san brahma nirvanam adhigacchati. Tapasan who is like this, yaha Antasukha. Antasukha means one who discovers the sukha, happiness within oneself in Atma. Do you seek happiness or not? Do you try to get happiness or not? Where? These verses can be known by contrast only. By contrast. We do seek happiness where? WhatsApp onwards. So, Vishaya, say Anta. Anta means where? Atmani. So, one who discovers, say, happiness in Atma. Anta Arama. One who sport, Krida, sports. Where are they? Antaha, Atmani only. Where is our Krida? If not anything, computer gives. This one. Atmani. Antaha, Jyoti. Jyoti is Prakasha. This Prakasha is within. What is your Prakasha? See, what is Prakasha? That light is the one which reveals the path. Our prakasha is Vishaya prakasha. We are full of Vishaya vrittis, which reveal what? Vishayas. His is Antar Jyoti. Antar Jyoti. His Vishvritti is the one which reveals Atma. What trust is there or not? That is what. So Antar Jyoti, not Vishayantak, Vishayantak Karna, Jyoti or Vishayat Jyoti. Yaha, bas, only this much you accomplish, nothing more, not. Only this one, you are who? Yogi, you are Brahma Jnani. Saha, that person is who? Yogi, here Yogi is Jnani. Not simply Yogi, Ashtanga Yogi, Jnani. And you know what about Jnani? Brahma Bhutaha. It's a very interesting word. Appears very simple. Brahma Bhutaha means who? One has become Brahma Bhutaha. Become. What has become? Brahma Bhutaha. So what it means, see, same word appears differently in different chapters of Bhagavad Gita, let us see. Finally, we will come to know what is meant by Brahma Bhutaha. This word meaning we find as Brahma Prapta in chapter 1854 Bhashya. Chapter 1854 Bhashya says Brahma Bhutaha means Brahma Prapta. And Brahma Prapta is further explained as Jivan Mukta in chapter 6 verse 27 Bhashya. And Jivan Mukta is none other than Jnana Nishtha described in chapter 1850 Bhashya, not Bhashya, verse. Look here. Brahma Bhutaha means Brahma Praptaha, Brahma Praptaha means Jivan Muktaha, Jivan Muktaha means Jnana Nishtha. You take any of the word but know the, which one you will pick up? Jivan Muktaha. I am taking Jivan Mukta Viveka, no? From 15th June at my place, only 14th place, no chance. Hindi, yes, it is Hindi. My Hindi is tolerable, not tolerable, it's very easy. It is not sophisticated Hindi, very easy Hindi. I didn't know. I am teaching in Hindi for the last 25 years. One class, 25 years. So it has become chaste. Of course, it's a learned language. It's a learned language, not just English. Only my Marathi is not learned language, but I had taught in Marathi also. But it is not a learned language. See, Jivan Mukta. See, other guy told you. Most of these people who teach Vedanta have not gone beyond the spelling of Jivan Mukta. All they say, Jivan Abhimukta. Liberated while living. I'm seriously telling this. I found this. Who is Mukta? Vimukta. Liberated. Who is that liberated person? One who is not afflicted by joys and sorrows. Suppose something joyous thing happens. What is your state? Suppose something troublesome comes. So elation and dejections are there. He is unperturbed. You know why unperturbed? His vision, his direct experience is such paramananda, in light of it, these pinpricks of life are just nothing. At times he is not aware of the body. I told you the case of Sadashiva Brahme. His arm was chopped off, it was hanging. He was not aware. See, he was not wearing that dress because he was not aware of the body at all. So he was just walking there. It happened that some Nawab or someone or some this thing had been at tent and he is walking at the harem. You got offended? Invented cutting. He's not aware, he's walking. Then he realized, he's not an ordinary person. He wanted to seek his apologies. He went in impervious, that is there. After 2-3 days, he could catch his attention. So what happened? Oh, he was not speaking, he was right. What happened? Well, you give also. If you get one pin prick, one needle, so you have to apply spirit or something. So what will happen? It is not imagined thing. It is so because mind is so well absorbed in the jivan api, means the vagaries of the world, because he is in the embodiment. So long as the embodiment is there, this sukha dukkhas are bound to be there. But he is totally unaffected. Why? Mind is absorbed where? In the Swarupa. He is jivan mukta. So what all things are necessary for jivan? Contrast between Vidya Mukti and Jiva Mukti. All these are thoroughly discussed in Jiva Mukti Veda. See, this generally, you must have heard, Vasana Akshaya, Manonasha, Tattvajnana. What you are dealing with is Tattvajnana. There are two other aspects are there, Manonasha and Vasana. These three have what a very important role. As far as Vidya Mukti is concerned, moksha after the prarabdha is over, tattva jnana is important, primary, pradhan. If you want to get totally unaffected by sukha dukkha right now, tattva jnana is necessary, where predominance goes to manonasha and vasanasha. A person who has got tattva jnana, but no manonasha, no vasanasha, will get vidya mukti, but will have to undergo the ups and downs of this lifeness. A person who has got mastery over the manonasha and vasanasha, no tattva jnana, no liberation. He may get better life, etc., he may get, but no liberation. Primarily what is necessary is tattva jnana, atma jnana to gain the moksha, vidya. But for Jivan Mukti, Manonasha and Vasanasha. Nowadays, those who speak of Vasanasha don't know even the definition of Vasanasha. We may know Vasanasha. They don't know even innate tendency, that's all. Much more than that. No doubt it is innate tendencies, but you have to explain, describe what are those innate tendencies. Fine. So now we say, Brahma Bhutaya Yuzu, Brahma Praptaha, what where? Gain Brahma, and who is Brahma Prapta? Jivan Muktaha. Jivan Muktaha, and who is Jivan Muktaha? Jnana Nishtha. One has got Nishtha, total abidance, sthiti in Jnana. What is Jnana? Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. What is Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana? What is Swarupa? You are substituted Atma for Swarupa. I want Jnana. I ask a person who is studying Vedanta. So how far you have studied Bhagavad Gita? Up to 10th chapter with Mahashapachavaya. Can you please tell me? You have heard this Siddha Pradnya. What is that meant by Pradnya there? Siddha Pradnya. What do you mean by Pradnya? I told you, Siddha Pradnya means of Sthita Pradnya Yasya Saha. In use of Sanskrit also. Sthira, Sthita means Sthira Pradnya. See, Pradnya is a general word. Any knowledge? He said yes. Means, I know, you translate the word knowledge of Atma. But what do you mean by Pradnya, that knowledge? Not that he forgot, it was not taught. They were not taught. They are Siddha Pradnya. You You want to know what is pratyaya? Brahma. Don't believe me. Big Sanskrit sentences you are giving. Brahmatmano shodhitayo eka bhavavagahini. I'll come word by word. Eka bhavavagahini. Nirvikalpa chinmatra vritti. Nirvikalpa chinmatra vritti. Because see, pratyaya word is for any knowledge pratyaya. Atmajnana pratyaya. But what exactly it means? Here what is the word? Jnana. This jnana is not different from pratyaya. What is that? Brahmatmano. Of Brahma as Ishvara, Atma as what? Jiva. Shodhita yoho. Actually, Shodhita means what? Purified. Purified means from Ishvara, strip off the Upadhi Maya. From Jiva, eliminate Upadhi Avidya. What it means? Ishvara minus Maya. What it means? Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya. Jiva minus Avidya, what it means? Shuddha Chaitanya. One and the same or not. So, Shodhita Yoho. Shodhita means Nirupadhika. Purified, ascertained, they say, with Nirupadhika. Brahmatmanoho Shodhita Yoho Eka Bhava Avagaini. Eka bhava means what? Eka vastu, eka swarupa, avagaini. Avagaini means vishayini. Vritti with vishayini means objectifies identity, eka bhava, oneness between jiva and Brahma. Well, purified means nirupadhika, and itself you know nirvikalpa. Bheda is not there. Triputi, I am knowing this, such a thing is not there. Nirvikalpa, so again, chinmatra. It is nothing but replica of Chaitanya, and Chaitanya only, free from anything anatma. That vritti. Even jnana means this one. Those who have studied Chatusutri, Brahma Sutra and forgotten. Jnanena hi pramanena Brahma avagantum shakya. How can you know Brahma? By pramana. What is pramana? Jnana sadhana. Means of knowledge. What is that means of knowledge? Jnana. See, contradiction is there in the statement. The Brahma Jnana can be gained by what? Jnana Pramana. How many word Jnana has come there? How can you know Jnana by Jnana? This word Jnanena differs. See, in Vedanta, don't get frightened, okay? The vritti which gives you the knowledge of a thing. Generally you say vishyakara or atmakara, generally tattadakara. Vritti of the thing which you are going to know. That vritti, that thought, secondarily is called jnana. You are supposed to know. Not primarily, secondarily. So unless that Atmakara vritti is there, you can't gain the. So that's why merely listening, the vritti will not come. Shuddhanta karana must be there. So that is it. So here, jnanishtha means visita prajna. Visita prajna means one who is Atmakara vritti is very steadfast, sthira. Brahma Bhuta, what does the sun, Brahma Bhuta say? Having become Brahma Bhuta Jnanishtha, Brahma Nirvanam Adhikacchati. Adhikacchati, Prapnoti. Again, Iha Eva means what? While in this human embodiment, now itself, not after death or not. But what should be the issue? Brahma Bhuta. What he gains? Brahma Nirvanam. Brahma Nirvanam means, literally means, repose, rest in Brahma. Where do you rest? On the bed. On sofa. In the Brahmani. Repose in Brahma means what? Mind absorbed where? In Brahma. Ashtu.
Yaha antaha sukaha.
Yaha antaha sukaha.
Antaha atmani.
Antaha atmani.
Sukham yasya.
Sukham yasya.
Saha antaha sukaha.
Saha antaha sukaha.
Yaha antaha sukha. So one who discovers sukha within, anta, inside. What is that antaha? It within atmani. So, atmani sukham yasya. One who discovers the sukha in atma. In contrast to a lay person who discovers sukha where? In visheshas. Sukham yasya, saha anta sukha, he is anta sukha. Continue.
Saha antareva atmani,
antareva atmani,
aramaha,
aramaha,
akrida,
akrida,
yasya, saha antara ramaha,
saha antara ramaha.
So, tatha, so also, then like anta sukha, so also, antaha eva, within only, what is within? Atmani eva, in atma itself, is what? Akrida. Akrida is what? Sports. Where is your sports? Fishes. Or with others. That fits the category of fishes. Just saha antarara. Again.
Tatha eva antaha.
Tatha eva antaha.
Atma eva jyotihi.
Atma eva jyotihi.
Prakashaha.
Prakashaha.
Yasya.
Yasya.
Saha antar jyotihi eva.
Saha antar jyotihi eva.
So the one whose prakasha is in atma only. This prakasha to be understood properly. See, as you already seen. What is it? Prakasha, that which reveals you. Suppose things are that here in the darkness. So light is necessary. So light there. So that which reveals. So what is it which reveals you? Says, Antaha Atma Eva Jyoti. For a lay person, Vishaya Antakarna Vritti Jyoti. What he perceives? Fishes. Who reveals? Vishakara Vritti. Here, what is revealed? Atma. Who? Atma Swarup. Here, Jyoti Prakasha means his Vritti or the mind is dwelling where? On Atma Swarupa. All Vritti he has got is Atmakara Vritti. Brahmakara Vritti means his mind or intellect doesn't depend on external objects through the media of sense organs or organs of actions. means it is a mind which is indriyadi prakasha janya shunyatva. Indriyadi prakasha shunyatva. Vritti is born of indriyas and panya vishayas are not there. What vrittis are there? Atma-sarupa vritti. His mind has become a replica of Atma-sarupa. Antar-jyotya, I say. So therefore, if you want to abide in Brahma, all that you have to do is accomplish only three, not more. What is that? Antar-aramaha. Antar-sukha, antar-arama, antar-vidya. Means only three qualifications. So, that you are to become. Continue.
Yaha idrushaha.
Yaha idrushaha.
Saha yogi.
Saha yogi.
Brahma nirvanam.
Brahma nirvanam.
Brahmani.
Brahmani.
Nirvritim.
Nirvritim.
Moksham.
Iha,
jivan eva,
jivan eva,
brahma bhutaha san,
brahma bhutaha san,
adigacchati,
adigacchati,
praapnoti,
praapnoti.
Yaha, whoever may be, idrisha of this type, with that idrisha, antarsukaha, antararama, antarjyoti, saha yogi, yogi arithnyani, brahma nirvanam, Brahmani nirvritim. Nirvriti means repose, rest. Repose, rest. Where? In Brahma Swarupa. In Brahma Swarupa. What is that? Repose in Brahma. That is what is called as moksha. That is what is called as what? You know what is, how moksha is defined? Swasvarupe avastha, swatmani avastha, abidance in Atma Swarupa. Are we not so already? See, well, we have studied some Vedanta. Our gross body, subtle bodies are where? Atmani. Atmani avasthanam. Atmani or vishaya avasthanam. Agri nāpa sarupa or vishaya. Vishaya. Mind very practically occupied. Vishaya. It is not Atmani avasthanam. In Atmani avasthanam, you are not aware of the vishayas. What is that? Mind is absorbed where? In the Atma sarupa. So that is why. All it is, elsewhere it is defined like this. You know what is moksha? Atma itself is moksha. But which Atma? Free from avidya and avidya karya. Thus, Atma itself free from avidya, self-ignorance and its defect, embodiment center. Presently, our Atma is what? Mixed with avidya, avidyakarya, sthula deha, sukshma deha, karana deha. Is it not? Only Atma. So it is nirvritim, moksham. When he gets after death, no. Iha eva. Iha means where? Jivan eva. While living, while in this embodiment. How? Brahma bhutaha asam. Vasyat Brahma bhutaha, Brahma praptaha, jivan bhuktaha, jnana nishtaha, arsita prajna. The Brahmavatasana adhigacchati praapnoti. He gets. further to add to this description, who gains Brahma Sarupa right now here while living, continue.
Kincha.
Kincha.
To add further. This is a style. Kincha. What further? Like you are. Swamiji, what is the next text? What further? Oh, this is not like next text, okay? Because the topic is still continuing. To add further.
Labhante Brahma Nirvanam.
Labhante Brahma Nirvanam.
Rishaya Kshina Kalmashaha.
Rishaya Kshina Kalmashaha.
Chinna Dvaitaya Tatmanaha.
Chinna Dvaitaya Tatmanaha.
Sarva Bhuta Hite Rataha.
Kshina Kalmashaha Chinna Dvaidaha Yatatmanaha Sarva Bhuta Hiterataha Rishayaha Brahma Nirvanam Labhante. Such people gain the moksha. Where? Here right now. Who are they? Number one. Kshina Kalmashaha. Kalmasha, Papa. So Papa means those who have cleansed themselves of sin, etc. Adi for Vishayasakti and also hankering for Vishayasakti. Kshina Kalmasha. Kalmasha means blemish. Literally, Kalmasha means blemish. Here, blemish in terms of papa. See, which papa? Past papa. You know what these papas do? They cloud your intelligence. They cloud your Viveka Buddhi. That is why Vedanta pursuit starts from where? Karma. Karma Yoga, have you heard at his name? Karma Yoga. Why? Mamo Pata Durita Kshaya Dwara Sri Parameshara Pityarthe Aham Idam Karishti. Past papas, duritas, you have no control over them now. Actions are already over. Actions are already over. So that is it. And what we experience now in life is what? From the past papa, sum total, which has right now, pratima. So therefore, whether I enjoy or suffer, do you know who is responsible for that, with the cause for it? Myself. Don't point out to others. When sorrow comes, and the Lord, best attitude, you know, not attitude, reminding yourself. Some bad lot is what? Getting exhausted. This is not to console anyone, this is the fact. The fact in the past, bad things are what? Getting collapsed. So, getting in the fact. So, what do you do? Because of that fellow, it is happening. So, like that, it's happening. Without cause, there is nothing whatsoever. Suppose something good, you only earned it. It may appear because of that. He favored me. That's why I got. For him to favor, there's a cause. What you had for him to frown, you are the cause. Because you had done something in the past. See, if it happened, if great sages like Vasishtha were there, they won't indulge in such things. For in every sorrow of yours, point out. this is the Jagrat, they don't do. If necessary, they dwell on it and they find it. So here afterward, whenever sorrow comes, what you have to think? That much is vibrant. Simple. I had undergone a major fracture surgery, hip surgery. One of my Guru Bandhu came. Hey, you seem to be very happy. I think some Duritaksha must have taken some Duritaksha must have taken place. It is true. It is true. Without calling, it is not possible. There is that call. No, Dhritarashtra story. Dhritarashtra was a born blind. Once he happened to be with Krishna and said, Krishna, why should I be born as blind? He said, wait. And what Krishna did? He started what is called action, not action, what is that?
Flashback.
All this WhatsApp paratha. I told him. Somebody said, BP. I said, what is BP? Display picture. I have to learn all this DP, display picture. Say, flashback. Started. Earlier life. Means he gave the sight of it. He gave the So it's the first earlier one was shown. No cause. Second, prior to that, no cause. He went up to 100. He said, Krishna, there's no cause at all. Wait, he said, 101. Cause was out. Without the cause, it is just not possible. It is just not possible. So therefore, this is not a consolation. This is knowing the fact. See, if you want to safeguard your interest, know the rule, as a citizen, know the rule and abide by the rule. Like this, in the laws of karmas, see, you know what it is. See, otherwise what happens? Sorrow of trouble and again distress. Oh, why should it happen to me? Why not others, etc.? Because you have earned it. Good or bad, you have earned it. Even a frown on the face, even a smile on the face is because of what? Past. Past is not an exaggeration. It is so. So that is why what happens? You try your best to get something and you don't succeed. No. Some past drag is. Don't get disheartened. Continue your effort. There is no alternative for efforts. You have to purusha prayatna is the means. But know for certain, because of drag of the past, at times you put little effort and the result is boom. Don't get elated. So there is some accelerating effect of the. So therefore, what is to be done? If paap ho gaya to kshina paap. Only one method is what? Paap akshalana. Paap akshalana. So paap. So how can it be the present karmas? I had to undergo physiotherapy. Fracture was here. Very painful. Somebody gave. Papakshalana is going on. Papakshalana is going on. That was the thing. Leg was not that painful, but this was painful. Papakshalana is going on. Papakshalana. So best, it's for that what is necessary is prayaschit, punitive action. Best punitive action is in Kali Yuga is Bhagavan Naam. In Kali Yuga. What is that is what? Bhagavan Naam. Okay. So here, Kshina Kadamasham means they have taken to, this in the past or this life and have gotten of the Duritas. Chinna Dvaidaha. Chinna Dvaidaha. Chinna Samshaya. Dvividha means doubt. So the one who has this destroyed all the Samshayas. Yatatmanaha. Yatatmanaha. That is Sanyatendriya. One who has got mastery over the Indriyas. Mastery over the Indriyas. Sarva Bhuta Hite Rata. Always engaged in the good, the service of all the people. Rishayaha. Rishaya means he is not our filmi duniya rishi. Sitting under the banyan tree with a tea stand, long silvery beard, not a tea. Rishi, Rishanti, Jananti, iti Rishaya. Those are what? Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. So they, Rishaya, what they? Brahma Nirvanam Labhanti. They gain Brahma Nirvana. They gain Brahma Nirvana. That is Moksha, they use.
Om Swasti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahi Manisha Gobrahmanebhya Shubhamastu Nityam Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Kale Varshatu Parjanyah Prithivi Sasya Shalini Desho Yamshova Rahitaha Brahmana Santu Nirbhaya Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha Sarve Santu Niramaya Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kanchit Dukha Bhavet Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.